captain of Team Red Balloon. So, Ken, who will you be attacking?
I'm going to Clashland.
Clashland. Yeah. All right. Well, then, best of luck to you for attacking and trying to get that 3-star.
Attacking the Brazilian Town Hall 12 setup over here. Clashland has got a really strong base. I'm curious to see if Ken can crack it. Now, Ken is really well known in the Chinese community for being an amazing Clash of Clans attacker. He's built some really interesting armies during our practice runs, and I'm interested to see how it goes in the real live event now.
Absolutely, and we saw Ken in practice. I mean, we were involved in the practice, just kind of having fun, and Ken was throwing around some Hog Riders, and we have yet to see any Hog Riders, so I'm kind of excited to see what attack strategy he actually throws down in this attack. Of course, it depends all on the base, and it looks like, oh, we guessed it! Ken is bringing the Clash, the Hog Riders, and I'm so stoked to see these things in action. One of my favorite troops in the game.
Keeping things a bit more grounded here, I like it. He's got the Hog Riders, a few bowlers, even some giants to soak some damage, but the thing I'm really looking forward to is, oh yeah, right at that left side, we've got the Wall Wrecker coming on in. Two hits even destroys those super high-level walls.
That's right, and I believe it's actually two hits for the max tunnel 12 walls as well. And it is just an absolute monster. It goes directly toward that town hall, no matter where it's deployed, whether there's a wall in the way or a defense in the way. It doesn't matter. That thing goes straight for it.
Lots of damage. Takes out that town hall early, but Ken is looking to try to get the 3-star here, and that's a very big, well-developed base. But there go the Hog Riders up on the top, the calls echoing throughout the map. We've got about 30 of them getting healed up now. What's going on, Klaus? Are they going to be able to make it to the bottom Inferno Tower?
You know, it's he's got 4 heal spells. Well, now he only has 2, but he's already deployed 2. He's got 2 left. 4 heal spells left, and that is the key for these Hog Riders. Keeping them alive is those heal spells. He's also got a queen with the queen ability. So at this point, I'd say he's looking pretty good. Very, very nice heal spell right there, by the way. That was beautiful. Healing up in the face of that giant bomb. He's only got a few defenses left, and again, that queen. Oh, that queen is she's struggling right now. Can't she get that double cannon?
Oh man!
Oh, in the last second,
giant bombs and bomb towers are very difficult for the Hog Rider to be able to make it through. But once they finally clear out the last defense, which they've just done, they'll start turning those hammers onto the skeletons, finishing those off, and they'll have an easy ride through the rest of the base. And look at the queen; she actually survives. A level 60 archer queen has just enough hit points to survive that entire base layout, and she'll help out a lot in the cleanup process. Looks like Ken is well on his way to a 3-star hit.
That's right. It looks like Ken is sitting on about 8-ish Hog Riders, which is a very nice ending to a hog attack. His queen looks like all you have to do is kind of like look at her wrong and she would die because she has no health left. And all there is left is, they're going to go for this king. Who's going to win the battle? 8 hogs or a single level 60 king? This is not looking good. It looks like the
he's
time.
Smashing them, but the buildings are finished.
It didn't matter. The buildings went down, and that's the 3-star for Ken.
Top 10 enemy betrayals of 2018. The Barbarian King failing to protect the buildings. Doesn't matter if he's standing up at the end. It's the buildings that count. Once they go down and there's no more left, it's a